Welcome to today's episode of Turnaround Thursday. Thank you so much for joining me. It is always a pleasure to spend a few minutes with you in the morning, in the evening, in the afternoon, whatever time you choose to listen, just to be in the presence of God along with you and to hear Him speaking to us. Next month, May 30, 2019, I will be celebrating 1 year of ministry via podcast. And so I issued a challenge last week, and I so appreciate the responses so far. And I want to continue to encourage you. If you listen via the Podbean app, you can send to your friends and your family, encouraging them to download the Podbean app and follow the podcast so you never miss an episode. And you can visit the website in order to download this app at revtcviews.podbean.com. That's revtcviews.podbean.com. revtcviews.podbean.com. If you listen via YouTube, then, of course, you can send to all your friends and your family and encourage them to subscribe. The target is 100 subscribers to the YouTube channel, 100 persons with the Podbean app by the time I celebrate my first anniversary of ministry via podcast. Thank you so much for joining me in this venture. And welcome and a big God bless you to persons who subscribed between last week and this week. Welcome, welcome, welcome. I trust that you have been blessed so far by the devotionals that are here and many more things to come. So thank you so much. God bless you. May 30, that's my first anniversary. Looking forward to having you continue with me as well as your friends and your family. Are you walking in the Spirit, or are you walking according to the flesh? In today's episode of Turnaround Thursday, I would invite us, I'd like us to reflect on the two things, walking in the flesh as opposed to walking in the Spirit. And I want to share with you from an article that I read by Jack Wellman. The title of the article is Five Differences Between Walking in the Flesh and Walking in the Spirit. Now, this is what the Bible says, and I want to read for you from Romans chapter 8, verses 5, 6, 7, and 8. This is what the Bible says. Those who live according to the flesh have their minds set on what the flesh desires, but those who live according to the Spirit have their minds set on what the Spirit desires. The mind governed by the flesh is death, but the mind governed by the Spirit is life and peace. The mind governed by the flesh is hostile to God. It does not submit to God's law, nor can it do so. Those who are in the realm of the flesh cannot please God. Are you walking in the Spirit? or are you living according to the flesh? If we are walking in the Spirit, my friends, it means that we are walking in a manner that is worthy of the Lord. It means that we are bearing fruit. We are bearing good fruit in every work, in every good work, and that we're increasing in the knowledge of God. How do we know that we're increasing in the knowledge of God? There is a hunger and a thirst after the word of God, and not just a hunger and a thirst after the word of God, but we are actually pursuing this word of God. We are studying the word of God. We're reading the word of God, and that is what we are about. We want to know more of God. We are engaging in the things of God, and we are living a life that is being led by the Spirit, where we consult the Lord God Almighty in prayer and ask for his wisdom in our day-to-day living and activities. But the person who is walking according to the flesh, they are all about gratifying the desires of the flesh. There will either be no fruit, if that is possible, or there will be bad fruit. Now, Romans chapter 6, verse 23 says that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus, our Lord. And you would have heard Romans 8, verse 5 to 8 just now. But I want to also point out to you the works of the flesh. Galatians chapter 5, 16 through to 18 says, so I say, walk by the Spirit, and you will not gratify the desires of the flesh. For the flesh desires what is contrary to the Spirit, and the Spirit what is contrary to the flesh. They are in conflict with each other, so that you are not to do whatever you want. But if you are led by the Spirit, you are not under the law. And I love that. So that you are not to do whatever you want. My friends, whenever we begin to conduct our lives in a way that whatever we do is just what about, it's just all about what we want, and we are doing it outside of consultation, prayerful consultation with the Lord, then we need to stop and check again. But let me quickly share this article with you that I read from Jack Wellman. 5 differences between walking in the flesh and walking in the Spirit. And I encourage you to look for the article and to read it for yourselves, the entire thing, because he gives very good explanations and biblical references in making these 5 points that I'm about to read to us. The first one is this. 5 differences between walking in the Spirit and in the flesh. The first one is this. Those who have the Spirit of God produce fruits that reveal whether they are a child of God or not. If there are no spiritual fruits, then God is not their Father. Those who have the Spirit of God produce fruits that reveal whether they are a child of God or not. That seems quite fair, simple, understandable, and biblical. Number 2, those who walk in the Spirit have crucified the flesh and do not submit themselves to the desires of the flesh. But those who don't walk in the Spirit grieve the Spirit, and their works producing nothing more than the wages that they have earned, and that is death, according to Romans 6:23. So it means then that the persons who are living according to the Spirit will seek to crucify the flesh, to put the flesh under subjection. Number 3, those who walk in the flesh, live according to the flesh, prove those who walk in the flesh, live according to the flesh, prove that they do by their works, but those who with the Spirit of God prove that they are Christ's, producing a Christ-like life. So let me read that again. Those who walk in the flesh, they live according to the flesh, and by their works they are proving that they are living according to the flesh. But for those who are living according to the Spirit of God, they prove that they belong to Christ by producing a Christ-like life. Wow. Isn't that amazing? Yes, I think so too. And then, let's look at the third one. Well, that was number three. We're moving on to number four. Those who walk in the flesh produce the fruits of the flesh, like sexual immorality, impurity, sensuality, idolatry, sorcery, enmity, strife, jealousy, fits of anger, rivalries, dissensions, divisions, envy, drunkenness, orgies, and things like these. That's according to Galatians chapter 5, verse 20 to the first part of 21. But those who walk in the Spirit will not gratify the desires of the flesh. And finally, those who put to death the deeds of the body or the deeds of the flesh are truly walking in the Spirit. But those who do not have the Spirit of Christ assuredly do not belong to Him. What is today's turnaround strategy? Today's turnaround strategy is this. People will hear your words, but they will see your fruit. Repent and walk in step with the Holy Spirit. Therefore, repent and walk in step with the Holy Spirit. And my question to you today, what does the fruit of your life reflect?
You come to us, we come alive.
Thank you, Jesus. Mighty God, your word declares that there is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus, because through Christ Jesus, the law of the Spirit who gives life has set us free from the law of sin and death. For what the law was powerless to do because it was weakened by the flesh, you, God, did by sending your own Son, Jesus Christ, in the likeness of sinful flesh, to be a sin offering. Therefore, He condemned sin in the flesh, in order that the righteous requirement of the law might be fully met in us, who do not live according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. Mighty God, we thank you this morning that in Christ Jesus we have life. And that this life is not just life, but it's abundant life. And by your Holy Spirit, God, we can live, bear good fruit, and keep in step with the Spirit. Lord, you are so good to us. Forgive us, mighty God, for walking after the flesh, for seeking to gratify the desires of our flesh, for being led by the flesh, for for not crucifying the flesh and putting the flesh under subjection. We repent this morning, mighty God. And we ask you, Lord, to forgive us, to cleanse us from all unrighteousness as we renew our commitment to you, and ask you, Holy God, to fill us with your Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We thank you, Lord, for what you are doing. We thank you, Lord, for loving us eternally and for embracing us with your love. In Jesus' name we pray. Can you say amen? Amen.